We are living through hard times in the modern era. What if the COVID-19 pandemic never goes away? Do we have to live with it forever? What if a vaccine is never developed? And what if herd immunity is never achieved? Is it going to become weaker and fade away? Or is it going to mutate and become more devastating and end up being a mass extinction threat? Let's speculate the extreme case scenario of the pandemic and break it down one by one today in this video of Discover Zen. First, let's understand more about COVID-19. COVID-19 is an infectious disease caused by a newly discovered coronavirus. Most people infected with the COVID-19 virus will experience mild to moderate respiratory illness and recover without requiring special treatment. Older people and those with underlying medical problems are more likely to develop serious illness. There might be a real-life scenario where a COVID-19 vaccine is never developed. No vaccination against any of the previous coronaviruses has ever been approved by the FDA. Rachel Roper, professor of microbiology and immunology at East Carolina University, also believes there is credible evidence to indicate that COVID-19 might just be resistant to vaccination. Now, let's see how our daily life will change in the scenario where no vaccine is developed for the virus. Using masks and maintaining social distancing will be the new normal. This transition will not be a problem, as we are used to seeing people wearing masks for the past few months during this pandemic. Dr. David Nabarro, a professor of global health at Imperial College London, who also serves as a special envoy to the World Health Organization on COVID-19, said that there are some viruses that we still do not have vaccines against. It's absolutely essential that societies get themselves into a position where they are able to defend against the coronavirus as a constant threat, and to be able to go about social life and economic activity amid the virus. As people will understand that there is no cure for coronavirus, they will try to be self-aware and cautious. Otherwise, they will be risking their lives. Moving on to daily lives. Full house movie theaters will be a thing of the past, as they will run at 1/3 of total occupancy, or even shut down, as everyone will prefer on-demand streaming services. The same goes for malls, as there will be strict rules for social distancing. Basically, every public space will run at a maximum of half of its total occupancy. Now, let's look at how our work will get affected. Most software companies will adopt remote work for most of its employees. Any hardware industry will run at half or even 1/3 of its workforce at a time. We might see some shift changes, like 8 hours of work from each employee at 1/3 of occupancy for 24 hours, which can compensate for the hardware building capabilities. In other words, every industry will adapt to the situation, even if the profit is reduced. Heck, who knows, all factories might even adopt robotic manufacturing, and human labor in these industries might become obsolete. Well, what about the tourism industry? This will be the most affected industry, as most travelers would now prefer traveling to only natural locations and not urban areas. So, the present urban tourist hotspots might be the least interesting spots to travel to. As for air and sea travelers, companies might provide you use-and-throw wearable gears before entering the flight. The space between each person would be much more. It might feel like the luxury of good old times of air travel. That would be super cool, I guess, right? The current duration for getting test results of the COVID-19 test takes between 30 minutes to 24 hours. Airports, malls, and every public area can have a more reliable 5-minute rapid testing procedure. Currently, it's not reliable, as the current rapid testing kits had accuracy issues, so it was called off for use. There could also be disinfection machines, and who knows what we could possibly be able to do in this modern era. The population will get the worst impact, and I do not mean it will reduce, due to the death rate of COVID-19. According to many surveys and websites, we're expecting a baby boom in the late 2020 and early 2021. All the above speculations are made, keeping in mind that, eventually, herd immunity will be achieved and the virus mutations will make it obsolete, which is the regular scenario in our history of pandemics. But let's take our speculation a bit further. What if no vaccine is developed and even herd immunity is never achieved? This can happen only in an unusual scenario where COVID-19 has to mutate fast, and every mutation makes it stronger to affect humans. If this extreme speculation becomes a reality, it can ultimately turn into a mass extinction threat for humanity. Let's see the case of the history's deadliest pandemic, the bubonic plague, also known as the Black Death, which is known to have wiped out 30 to 50% of Europe's population. At that time, in the 14th century, people thought that the bubonic plague was the end of humanity, and it was quite close to our extreme speculations. During this time, it was thought that a vaccine could never be found for the plague, and herd immunity would never be achieved. Still, Homo sapiens are a pretty intelligent species, and eventually, a vaccine was found and the plague was eradicated. Similarly, we will find out a way to eradicate the coronavirus too. And don't worry, because for this speculation to become a reality for COVID-19, there's only one way. COVID-19 should be a fast mutating virus, like the Spanish flu or the bubonic plague, but it's not. COVID-19 is a slow mutating virus, and some mutations make it stronger, and some make it weaker. Therefore, there's no possibility of this extreme case scenario to become a reality. In the best case scenario, we're looking at a vaccine to be developed and available in the next 6 to 12 months, and then we can return to our normal lives. In any case, it's always best to take care of yourself with precautionary measures. Wash your hands, use masks in public places, and don't travel for unnecessary reasons. Thank you for watching our first video. Subscribe to our channel to watch more speculative content, and give us a thumbs up if you love this video. Comment your thoughts in the YouTube comment section. Also, if you would like to suggest a video topic, you can mention your suggestion in the comments section below.